Hello, I am Erwan Jolivet from CESAR. I am a biomechanical engineer, so I'm not a programmer, so a real programmer. And this session talk about paper scaling. So first, we will have an overview of the scaling in a few minutes, and then we go through modules developed and implemented in the paper framework, with some application, real demo, and last, we have a summary and conclusion with a discussion at the end of the session. So, first, scaling HVM is not a new idea. It has the potential to help for increasing the performance of safety approaches, taking into account for human vulnerability, modeling sample population. So in fact, it can increase the robustness of safety systems, account for more variability of the population. It can also improve the human body models itself for model validation, to perform some model-specific simulation according to some PMHS testing. Also, we can conduct some parametric studies on human models to have a better understanding of the influence of shape variability in model responses. From the pool, as been presented before, we have some information from the user point of view. First, apparently, global scaling is more higher request than more fine local scaling. There is a lower interest for regional anthropometry. But global, we'll see that later on, global descriptor is not sufficient to define and perform a scaling of the model. However, for some applications, there is some more requirements regarding children on R1 regulation for R1 2029 with specific anthropometry described, or other trends like obese and something like that. What are the challenges in scaling? First, how we can describe the targets. In many situations, you have only some few descriptors that can define the target to transform the human body model. In perspective, we can provide the target that describes the average person of a set of descriptors, like the 50th percentile stature. We can improve this first set of targets using several types of information. We can provide some external descriptors, like anthropometry, using database, existing database, and statistical models built on this database. We can also add some internal descriptors, enhancing the target with also the statistical model constructed from this descriptor, from landmarks or surfaces, generated from medical images, for example, one strong limitation is the availability of such data for the full body as the full body level. So this is one strong limitation of such approach. Another one is the relation between those internal and external descriptors. We have some, for example, for fat thickness at the torso level, but what about other regions? Regarding the transformation method itself, we have some requirements and limiting challenges. We have to preserve the mesh quality to be able to run the model after a transformation in a crash simulation. We have also a subjective quality criteria, the acceptability from the user of the result of the deformed shape of the model. And the current method used usually in literature seems to use some smoothing or reflection process to smooth the deformation. Those methods are mostly based on control point for kriging, LBF and other. But there are some limitations regarding the size of the problem, the number of points we consider to define the transformation. So this is numerical limitation. The last challenge is how we can define those targets on the human body model. The link between the model and the target can be critical. It can be posture dependent. Sometimes it is done manually, not documented, and very model specific. So we try to find a solution inside the Piper framework for that.